Let's talk about the three things you need to know about high cholesterol and menopause. First, did you know that during menopause, our cholesterol levels can creep up? I certainly know that my weight could creep up, but I didn't know that my cholesterol levels could until I sat down with a brilliant and well-respected cardiologist recently. That conversation sent me rushing off to make an appointment with my own doctor. Second thing to know is that high cholesterol doesn't have any symptoms. It doesn't make you feel bad. So the only way to know if you have it is to go to the doctor and have it tested. The third thing to know is that high cholesterol is a major risk factor for heart disease. Some cholesterol is just naturally in our bodies, but when we have too much of it, especially that bad cholesterol, the low density lipoprotein LDL cholesterol, that can deposit in our arteries when there's too much of it and cause something called plaque. When that plaque builds up, it can clog up that artery and stop the flow of blood. When that happens, whatever that artery was supplying doesn't get the blood it needs. If that thing is your heart, that causes a heart attack. If it's your brain, that causes a stroke. That's why it's so important to pay attention to your cholesterol levels. So, what do we do with all of that information? Well, I recommend, especially for women around menopause, that you have a real candid conversation with your doctor about all of your risks, your family history, your diet, everything, so that you can be a partner in your own healthcare. Certainly, diet and exercise are very important, but some of us just are more prone to high cholesterol. So if you're prescribed something to lower your cholesterol, please make sure that you are very open with your doctor about any side effects or challenges you may be having. I was shocked to learn in a recent survey that less than half of people prescribed a statin to lower their cholesterol talked with their doctors about the challenges that they may be having. And even more concerning, half of them will stop taking that medication within the first year. If you need a little help having that conversation with your doctor, I highly recommend you visit the TakeCholesterolToHeart.com website. You'll find some great tools to prepare for your doctor's appointment and be ready to go in and have a great conversation.